Hello everyone, this is Madhutarap. This video we are going to see byte strings. In case if you are going to read or write image file, video file which are in the byte format, so you will be using the byte strings. In Java at high level we will be having two byte string information or two byte string classes which are for input stream and for the output stream. These both classes are the abstract classes so that you cannot create the object for these classes. However, we can have the different implementation. Based on our scenario, we can choose the different implementation. For instance, you can consider you are going to read a binary data or byte information from the console, you will be using the buffered input stream. Or let's say if you are getting the information from the file, then you will be using the file input stream or file output stream. So basically, you will be reading and writing the data of the byte format. So that's the reason you will be having the read method and write method in both the classes. So let's consider a different example for reading the image file from the system, and you will be writing the image file to the other file by using the byte reading. So in this class, we are going to create a file input stream instance and a file output stream instance. File input stream instance needs the path for the given file, and this file information will be read in the format of byte stream. So simply in the line number 14, you are just opening the stream to read the byte information for the given file. Let's say if you don't have the information or if you don't have the file itself, you will be having the file not found exception. The same for the file output stream, it is just creating an empty container or empty file so that whatever the data you want to just write to the file, you can do that. But however, in this line, you are just making an empty file and you are just making a passage, just like to write the different kinds of byte stream. And after that, you will be having the input stream having the method called available to see how many bytes are available for the given file. And after that, you will be having the read method. So it will be reading each and every byte one by one, and it will be just giving to you. In case if you don't have any bytes to read further, then you will be having the value as minus one. So that's the reason in while loop, we are just reading until we reach the end of the byte or end of the file. So in both cases, you are just making the passage for the given stream. It can be input stream or output stream, but it has to be finally closed. So that's the reason we will be having the finally block just to close the input and output streams respectively. Now, before going to the other information, just we will understand so what are called images and what are the different things that we can understand at very basic level. So whatever the images you will be having in your hand, so that will be having the pixels. So which means that even though it looks like an image, if you zoom very deeply, you can see the pixels, and each pixel will be just like a cell, which will be having some color. That color will be represented by some byte information. So that is the byte we are going to read one by one from your left-hand side to right-hand side, and it will be from top to top. So just imagine here you will be having a small pixel, a zoom-in version. You can see the different pixels here. So every color will be represented to the byte information. So the entire image will be represented as a collection of bytes. So those bytes we are reading in our file, and we are just writing to the another file. So let me refresh this package. And here you can see there are no files called logo underscore copy.png, and you can execute this file. And here you can see we have already read it and we have already wrote to the file. The file name will be like logo underscore copy. So better I will refresh at the project level. Refresh, and here you can see logo copy. So this is the logo copy and this is the logo. So this way we have just copied the image file byte by byte from the file input stream, and we have written those bytes to the file output stream, which is the file name called logo underscore copy.png. So here we have the output called 4369 bytes are available. Just to confirm that one, we will go to the same folder, just see the logo.png for example and click on properties, and here you can see 4369 bytes. So this confirms that we have read all the bytes from the given file. So however, this will be the integer character, and we have seen something called byte information, which is nothing but a collection of 8 bits. But let's say if I just put the breakpoint here, line number 20, and let me delete that file again. Okay, now just run as a debug mode. Here you can see. Okay, just switch to the debug mode and go to the next line. For the C value, here it is 137. So we have discussed that is the byte information. Even the byte can be represented as the integer, which will be ranging from 0 to 255. In case if you want to see the very byte information or very bit information, you can go to the calculator and you can switch to the programmer mode and you can type the same value 137. You can see the a binary information for the given byte, which will be considering the 8 bits of data for the given byte. So this way you can see even a very granular level, you can go to the very bit level. So what is the data being read from the image? And we can test some more things, something like, let's say if you don't have the file, are we getting the error or not? So terminate this one and just run it again. And you will be having the exception called file not found exception. The similar fashion here, you are just creating the container. Even before you write it, or even if you don't write it, this file will be created automatically because you are creating the output stream. Okay, fine. So this way we have understood that. So how to read the byte information from the image file or the audio file or the video file. For example, we have seen the image file PNG format. In a similar fashion, you can use any data. Any data in the sense, digital data such as like images, files, like audio files, video files, and so on. So this concludes our video for the image processing, let's say image file reading using the Java input stream and output stream. So thanks all. Thanks for watching and have a great day.